The Harvard Herbarium is really a cornerstone of biodiversity science here at the university and has been since 1842 when it was founded. A herbarium is a collection of pressed and dried plants and fungi that represent sort of snapshots of places and times, and they are in many ways our best representation of where plants and fungi have lived in the past, which is really crucial to thinking about how those trajectories may change moving forward. What you see is a representative of the 5.5 million collections of largely pressed and dried plants that represent one of the best ways to understand and to study nature without being in nature itself. The traditional use of herbaria and natural history collections more broadly is really for understanding what are the species and where do they live. But in the face of global change and climate change, these collections are seeing kind of a renewed purpose. And so that is specifically for climate change investigations. It's also for understanding genomic and genetic changes that relate to not just climate, but how humans have domesticated species, moved them around the planet. I would argue that digitization, like DNA sequencing, is easily one of the biggest sort of revolutions in biodiversity science in the last 100 years. There are about 3,000 herbaria around the world, and these contain nearly 450 million specimens. Most of these specimens remain unavailable to the world. What digitization does is that it greatly reduces the barriers to entry for a variety of scientists, policymakers, even artists. What's really intriguing to me is that it's balanced by this kind of scary moment in Earth's history where we're losing lots of biodiversity, where there's this kind of grand experiment going on. We can learn and understand the resiliency of nature and how they respond or don't respond to some of these changes. And herbaria are very much centered within that communication and that conversation.